have a huge machining project. You are going to see how this
is turned into one of those. So we have the first one in the machine and second one is there. And it's going to be a great video.
And as you can probably see, we are not on our own workshop. This is filmed at Atakiars, my friend works there, and they are largest custom bevel gear manufacturer in the world. And this is quite like custom gear. It's not your typical bevel gear. It's not very complicated shape, but it's absolutely huge. The raw material here being lifted to the machine weighs 10 tons and it's the maximum of their grain, so this is the largest one that you can make here. And it was also quite large for the machine, it barely fits through the doors. And it was really interesting to see that lifted there, because on the press 10 tons, that's like not force at all. But when you actually see 10 tons of steel, that's like, that looks really heavy. And I think we are going to look the 10 tons on the press quite differently after seeing this 10 ton raw material being lifted into the machine. But there it is now on the machine. And I didn't film when they like clock it in. It was quite a lot of work to get it on the center. And now they just started to open the grooves on the gears. And the piece was so large that there wasn't room in the machine for the mill head to turn to go same direction as the grooves goes. So they had to like do this small motion and go like horizontally in and out. So it wasn't as fast as usual when you can turn the mill head. And here are the tools that they use, so just regular mill heads, nothing too fancy. The finishing tools are shaped a bit more like purposely for just this thing, but the opening face, it's just regular mill heads. And this is my time lapse. I think the camera was in total of 80 hours on, so it took some time. I have no idea how much faster it would be if there would be just slightly more room for the mill head to turn on the right position to go like bit longer strokes. And they use first bit shorter tool, so it's more rigid. And then when they have the like all grooves open, like halfway, then they switch to longer mill head and do the rest of the bay. As you can see, it has to go quite deep because of the orientation on like bottom part of the grooves. But it was still really quiet, it didn't shake or any like loud noises. And you could even like, you didn't need like wearing protection next to machine. It was really quiet, almost like laundry machine or something like that. It was surprisingly quiet. Usually when we like mill some stuff, it's always really loud. And while the first one was in the machine, they analyzed the second one with the ultrasound to see that there isn't any cracks inside of the material before they machine it, to make sure that it's going to be strong enough. And now when the all grooves are open and most of the material is removed, they switch to finishing tools that won't remove much material at all. It's just like, I don't know how much, probably like half a mil or something like that is removed with these, and they make the like final form of the gear. So this gear and the gear that is driving this, they have like perfect contact and it's smooth and everything.
Okay, they are ready, both of them. I think it was like 2 weeks or something. I'm not sure. They were on the list after they come out from there. I'm not sure what they did. Probably something to these surfaces, maybe, I'm not sure. Some finishing touches, but it was different company. Yeah, but they are really nice and look really expensive. I have no idea what they cost. And these are not the most complicated gears that you can make. They're just really large. And people seem to like large things for some reason. But we are going to film also probably some bit more complicated things here. And they have also giant heat treatment facility that we are going to also film probably on future videos. So let us know down in the comments what kind of machining videos you would like to see. Is it better to be large or complicated? And if you like the video, hit the thumbs up, and if you don't, thumbs down, so we know what to make in future. And huge thanks to Atakiars for letting us to film this. I'm pretty sure that it's going to get a lot of views. And I leave some links to their home pages if you want to check out what else they make. Yeah, but that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.